playing.
No, the recording. I've got a couple. I mean, what do you expect me to do?
Back up.
Yeah.
Just keep standing there, Charlie. If she goes 1 inch forward,
I have it on repeat. I can wait here all day. So. Have a good day.
1 inch forward, and I'm going to turn her into a Mexican.
Yeah, he can. Suck
hey,
it.
Did you pass that stimulus check? Did you pass that 1200?
I can't hear you.
I'm pretty sure you can. Don't ask though.
$1,200
hey,
check.
Hey, tell me the
best.
Did you?
Well, yeah.
Hell yeah, he's our president.
He's
just like he should.
Four more years. Four more years. We love you and so does Trump. Have a good day, ma'am.
Oh, I'm having a great day. I hope you all do. I'll see you
at NASA.
Get out of my way.
No, we're not moving.
He's going to love
I'm
you for four more years.
I'm just going to keep playing until you get out.
It's okay.
We're not moving.
You should blast the music louder. That Prius has awesome bumps.
Can you trust Spencer Iger?
Turn it off.
The louder. Give me some.
Bumper sticker you should check out too. Go ahead and get a video.
I'm curious what it says. Hey, hey, is that your husband on? Is that your husband back there?
I noticed
some bumper sticks. I thought maybe that was your husband. No.
Well, you came through here.
I guess I'll have to.
You came through here already.
I'm not turning around. Move the fuck out of my way.
And I never give a fuck because I'm celibate. To find the time and find that you're relevant.
Okay, do it.
She won't move. So
Skylar, back up.
I've already asked you guys to move five times. Die at the fucking parking lot!
Yeah, it came through here doing some stupid shit, so what do you fucking expect to happen?
It's not stupid to it's my right to express my opinion. Okay, this is America! This is America!
You came back around!
Move out of my way!
No!
Okay, I'm not backing up.
Don't engage.
I guess I'll just keep playing. I don't know why you guys...
Stand here.
I'll
move. All right. Little.
Medium, dude. Guess
not
I'll
even...
keep going. It's
not... What the fuck you do? And I never give props to a punk ass chick. Nigga, fuck Donald Trump. He can suck my dick. Fuck Donald Trump. Fuck Donald Trump.
Hey, you know that?
Hey, adios.
Bro, Michael Cross, Attorney General.
Bye, bitch.
Now she's gonna get in the rack.
Yeah.
Oh, now she has a nigga take suck my dick, huh?
Stay right there.
Michael Cross here, the Republican nominee for State Attorney General. We are having a great time today. Wonderful time. We got some fans coming over, honking their horns. They're having a great time as well. We've made it their day.
You know, it's so nice to see you.
You're a fucking racist. Bye-bye.
I think you are.
Violated ORS 433.441, paragraph 5. We went into 28 days closure in the state. And if she wanted more than that, she needed to convene the state legislature. So she failed to do that because she knew she didn't have the votes. So, you know, and businesses are paying the price, people are losing their jobs, and it's just, it's really bad. And,
but what
and
if we could just
it's,
come
it's
around
not right.
Doing that?
Where I was at last night was Ben's great restaurant in Seaside. Leaving there about 9:45, about six people came in, and they were told they had to leave and go eat at McDonald's. So Finns lost out if they were purchasing alcoholic beverages, probably about $300. That's just one instance, and this is statewide. People, the damages to our state is in the billions for this unlawful order from Kate Brown. And then on Monday, last Monday, in a Zoom conference call with Ellen Rosenblum, she told me that she works for Kate Brown. And sad to say that I had to correct the woman, a twice elected judge, 8-year incumbent as a state attorney general, thinks that she works for Kate Brown. So I had to explain that no, if you did work for Kate Brown, that would be an appointed position, but you are, of course, elected, and so therefore you work for your constituents, we the people of Oregon. And that actually explains her actions of late, thinking that she works for Kate Brown. Because you see, all attorneys take an oath, they will zealously defend their clients. So basically, no matter what Kate Brown does, Ellen Rosenblum is going to protect and defend that woman. And that's wrong. That's dead wrong. And that's against the Constitution and should not be happening. That's why I'm running. So vote Michael Cross. Our website is michaelcross4oregon.com. Either way works, Michael Cross, number 4, or FOROregon.com.
Okay.
So, and I've made the pledge that any fines levied against businesses, I work for myself most of my life, and I get it. I do get it. And it's wrong. So I made the pledge that all fines from the OLCC or OSHA, for instance, there was a pharmacy in Lakeview that was fined $10,000 in 15 minutes, and it was wrong. That's going to put them out of business. That is the only pharmacy in a 90-mile range. So, you know, I've made the pledge, and I will do this, that after getting elected, all those fines are going to be waived. Because it's an unlawful order, people. It's unlawful, and it should not be happening. And it's crushing businesses. It's crushing businesses. I have a solution to the homeless problem. The solution to the homeless problem, unfortunately, many of these people have addiction issues, be it alcoholism, drugs, or things like that. And so we'll deal with that issue first. And you know, the folks that have the best track record of dealing with those issues are the nonprofits, like churches, AA, NA, people like that. There's a great program called Celebrate Recovery. So we'll deal with that first, and then after that, the trades are screaming for people. Then we can train them on a career of their choice. I'm talking about plumbers' apprentices, electricians' apprentices, carpenters, mechanics, things like that. And we basically be building a small town somewhere over in Eastern Oregon, and I will be partnering with manufacturing companies as well, companies like Intel, Nike, any manufacturer that's in Oregon is welcome to participate. I'd love to hear from those folks so we can help solve this homeless issue together. So it's about a 3-year program, and at the end of that, they will be eligible to purchase their own home with any kind of standard bank loan. It's a great deal because that accounts for about a 1-year program to deal with the recovery issues, the addiction issues, and it's not going to cost much because there's a lot of tax dollars out there from the federal government to deal with the opioid crisis, the epidemic, and things like that. They're also eligible for Social Security disability. And by my estimation, this is rough cost right now, about $4.5 million is what that program will cost, and we'll have a zero population for homeless because they'll have jobs and place to stay, and it's a promotion incentive-based program, and it's great. So yeah, I can't wait to get in there and solve these issues, and that's all it's going to be, and then Oregon will have a zero homeless population, and it's an ambitious program, no doubt, but I believe that other states we'll be looking at this and we'll be utilizing this program because it's going to be successful. And it's going to bear that out. It's going to bear that out. I know it will. So I have a solution to censorship on social media. Who hates censorship on social media? Is that a problem or what? That is a problem. That is a problem. Well, here's the thing, and here's where they screwed themselves. Social media is, in my view, the modern day equivalent of the town square. So the problem is that they went ahead and accepted ad revenue for political causes, candidates, and issues. Mm-hmm. And by doing that, not allowing people to talk the pros and cons of the issues and the candidates is not right. So they are the modern day equivalent in town square. Pretty much everybody has a Facebook account. Everybody has this kind of thing. Now, if they were strictly limited to hobbies, like woodworking, car mechanicking, landscape, hiking, fishing, hunting, and somebody wanted to talk politics in there, then they would have a basis to say, I'm sorry, you can't talk politics, this is a hobby group. But they have not done that. And they are not the truth czar. They don't get to decide what's true and what's not true. I mean, think about it. If we don't nip this in the bud now, can you realize what a scary world we will become with some corporation determining what's fact and what's fiction and what you can talk about and what you can't talk about? So it is a modern day equivalent in the town square, and I have a solution for that, and we will get Facebook to stop that in Oregon. And that's what we need to do. Can I get a hoo-wah for that?
Hoo-wah! Hoo-wah.
These annoying robocalls, those are illegal, especially if they come to your cell phone. I will set up a fund for that, and we will make the companies that are doing that pay. And so if you are a victim of these harassing robocalls, take a screenshot of the call, the phone number. We will track down who owns that phone number and who made that call. And then you will then email that information in to the claims department, and you'll be compensated. Whatever's in the kitty, we're going to divide it. So maybe $50 per phone call. I don't know. It depends on how much is in the kitty. But wouldn't that be nice for every annoying robocall that you got, you were paid $50.
Hey. It's